Hello and welcome back to JPzilla. With G-Fest coming up, I've been working on a costume to show off at the parade, and working on that costume got me thinking about the character. Juggler. We know a lot about him, considering he's been in 3 series and several spin-off movies. But he's still a man of mystery, and that mystery is how did he get his powers? We saw Juggler get his powers in Ultraman Orb, the Origin Saga, but we still don't really know how. So in this video, I will explore 3 theories on how and why Juggler got his powers. Possibility 1. The power itself chose him. In the Ultraman series, sentient power is relatively common. In the same series where Juggler takes on his mysterious Majin form, his comrade Guy is chosen by the Orb of Light to become Ultraman Orb. In fact, Juggler has already been shown to have been selected by another semi-sentient dark power, the Dark Ring, which is revealed in Ultraman Orb the movie to choose a person with the most evil mind in the universe, quote-unquote, as its bearer, kind of like another famous ring from another famous story. It is very possible that Juggler inherited his Majin powers from a mysterious form of sentience who saw Juggler as an opportune host and latched on. Possibility 2. The Tree of Life gave him power. The Tree of Life plays a central role in Ultraman Orb, the Origin Saga. It is a huge and powerful tree central to the culture of Planet Kanon. It also bestows a special power to the princess of Planet Kanon, allowing her to transform into a huge off-brand Ultra Woman referred to as the War Deity in order to defend her planet. In an attempt to attain the power of the Tree of Life, an evil scientist named Dr. Psyche uses bug kaiju with mind control venom to try to take the Tree of Life. The antidote to this mind control venom is actually the fruit of the Tree of Life itself. At one point, Juggler is affected by this venom known as Kugutsu, and is basically stabbed with a piece of the Tree of Life to return him to normal. While it is never confirmed that stabbing him with the Tree of Life gave him any special abilities, the Tree of Life's powerful properties, which have been shown to impart Ultraman-like power before, is the most substantial in-show explanation for Juggler's mystifying transformation later in the series. Heck, the War Deity and Juggler even look a bit similar, so it's actually very possible that the Tree of Life had something to do with his powers. Possibility 3. Juggler willed it into being. This possibility is what I like to call the Legend of Zelda alternative. And if you'll allow me to elaborate on the game series for a bit, it will come around to Juggler again, so hold on to your butts. If you don't know anything about this game series which I'm referencing, what you need to know is that it takes massive inspiration from Japanese religion, which actually consists of 2 religions, Shinto and Buddhism. In the game Breath of the Wild, the antagonist, a force of nature named Calamity Ganon, uses a purplish-red substance translated as malice to create monsters, take over giant mechas, infect the landscape, and poison creatures which would be considered deities in Japanese culture. In the sequel, Ganondorf, who may or may not be Calamity Ganon, it's kind of complicated, uses this power to transform himself into a demon king. While this power is anglicized as malice in the English translation, the actual Japanese term for this substance is jiaki. Slight correction here, after a bit more research, I found out that the term jiaki has mostly been used in Zelda games predating Breath of the Wild, and the term used for malice in Breath of the Wild is actually onen, while the power that Ganondorf uses in Tears of the Kingdom is referred to as shoki. The distinction, as far as I know, is rather minimal, so I will continue to use the word jiaki throughout the rest of this video. And it actually has significant roots in Japanese mythology. Jiaki is basically a natural byproduct of negative emotions which can transmutate people into horrifying monsters like Calamity Ganon or Demon King Ganondorf. And if we look at what is happening to Juggler, this actually matches to a T. Juggler just lost someone and feels responsible for her death. He's also experiencing repressed jealousy at being passed up by the Orb of Light to become an Ultraman, which may be exacerbated by the fact that if he was given the power of Ultraman, he could have potentially saved her. And it's getting fed up with this war over a stupid tree. This is a lot of negative emotion hitting Juggler all at once, and it shows. When he transforms, he starts to ooze a purple energy that actually looks a lot like malice, or jiaki. And later on, his power takes on a reddish tint that even reflects this malice further. Taking a step back from Japanese mythology and looking at the Ultra series itself, there actually is a Jyaki equivalent which takes a prominent role throughout the whole series. First introduced in Ultraman 80 and being referenced many times afterwards, minus energy is the energy of negative emotions which is responsible for physically manifesting monsters like this crybaby here. Minus energy is essentially the scientific name for Jyaki, and while it is never, to my knowledge, shown to manifest as a purplish red substance like malice, the concept is exactly the same. In my mind, this third alternative is probably the most likely just because it seems to fit in with the story the most and has clear roots in Japanese storytelling. Juggler wasn't really evil at this point, so it doesn't make much sense for an evil power to latch onto him like in the first scenario unless it was playing the long game. And there are other entities crueler than him which he could have latched onto at the time, like for instance Dr. Psyche. For the second scenario, Juggler's powers of darkness don't really mesh with the Tree of Life's wholesomeness, so unless his powers were a fusion of the poison and the Tree of Life's power, this is also unlikely. The third scenario fits a lot with Juggler's story as an outcast, the unchosen one who forges his own destiny, the jealous ally fueled by vengeance, and the reddish substance is easy to identify with malice or Jyaki. So I'm inclined to think that this alternative is the most likely. But what do you think? This is still a big mystery in the Ultra lore, so I'd like to hear your thoughts in the comments down below. Until then, this has been JPZilla. Oh, and do that liking, commenting, and subscribing stuff while you're at it.